Ever wondered how your favorite whey protein is made? Well, it all starts with the humble cow, believe it or not. You see, whey protein is actually a byproduct of cheese production from cow milk. That's right, the same milk you pour over your morning cereal is the starting point for this power-packed nutrient supplement. Now, you might be thinking, any old cow will do, right? Not quite. The cows that provide the milk for whey protein are raised specifically for milk production. These aren't your average bovines. They're kept in good health and are fed a well-balanced diet to ensure the milk they produce is of the highest quality. After the milk is collected, it's pasteurized to ensure safety. This process involves heating the milk to a specific temperature for a set period of time to kill any harmful bacteria. So it all begins with the humble cow and its nutritious milk. And after collecting the milk, it's time for the first step, pasteurization. Now, this isn't just a fancy term we throw around. Pasteurization is the all-important process that ensures the milk we use is safe. This is achieved by heating the milk to a specific temperature for a set amount of time, effectively killing any harmful bacteria that might be lurking within. There are two main methods we use for pasteurization: high temperature short time and ultra high temperature pasteurization. The first, high temperature short time, or HTST, involves heating the milk to about 162 degrees Fahrenheit for about 15 seconds. On the other hand, ultra high temperature pasteurization, or UHT, heats the milk to an even higher temperature of 280 degrees Fahrenheit, but for a shorter duration of just 2 seconds. Each method has its benefits, but both share the same goal: to ensure the milk is safe and ready for the next steps in our whey protein production process. Pasteurization ensures the safety of the milk, setting the stage for the next step. Now, the magic begins with curdling the milk. You see, milk is a cocktail of nutrients that includes, among other things, proteins. The most prevalent proteins in milk are casein and whey. But to get to that whey, we first need to curdle the milk. Curdling is a simple process that involves adding rennet to milk. Rennet, which is an enzyme, acts on the casein proteins in the milk, causing them to coagulate or come together. This results in the formation of curd, which is the solid part of the milk. Now, this curd is the stuff cheese is made from, but we're more interested in the liquid part that's left behind. This liquid, full of whey proteins, is what we're after. So, by curdling the milk, we're essentially separating the solids from the liquids, the cheese from the whey, you see. The process of curdling not only gives us cheese, but also our precious whey. After curdling, it's time for separation and another round of pasteurization. Now that we've successfully curdled the milk, we have two components on our hands: solid curds and liquid whey. The solid curds are set aside for cheese making, while the liquid whey, our star player, moves on to the next round. The whey, though liquid, isn't quite ready for its transformation into protein powder just yet. You see, this liquid contains bacteria which, while beneficial in the cheese-making process, aren't necessarily welcome in our protein powder. And that's where pasteurization comes in for the second time. During this second pasteurization, the whey is heated to a very high temperature for a short period. This heat treatment effectively kills off any lingering bacteria, making the whey safe and ready for the next steps in the process. With the second pasteurization, we ensure that our whey is not only safe, but also of the highest quality. With this, we're a step closer to our final product. The separated whey now undergoes concentration and isolation. This is where the science of whey protein really starts to get interesting. The goal here is to maximize the protein content while minimizing any unwanted elements. And how is this achieved, you might ask? Through two main methods: membrane filtration and ion exchange technology. Let's delve into membrane filtration first. It's a bit like a super efficient sieve designed to filter out the stuff we don't want while keeping the good stuff. This process removes bacteria and fat from the whey, retaining the proteins, carbohydrates, and minerals. It's an intricate dance of separation, a process of sifting and sorting on a microscopic level to yield a product that's lean, clean, and protein-packed. Now on to ion exchange technology. This process isn't about removing unwanted components, it's about selectively isolating specific protein components. It's like being at a party and only inviting your favorite people to join you in the VIP section. The ion exchange process works based on differences in charge, separating the proteins we want from those we don't. This method is highly effective and results in a protein isolate of superior purity. These two methods, membrane filtration and ion exchange technology, work in tandem to concentrate the protein in whey while eliminating unwanted components. They're like the gatekeepers of the whey protein production process, ensuring that only the highest quality proteins make it through. So in essence, the concentration and isolation stage is all about refinement. It's about taking the raw, separated whey and transforming it into a highly concentrated protein source. It's about ensuring that when you scoop that powder into your shake, you're getting the very best that whey has to offer. These processes ensure we're left with the best parts of whey. The result? A high-quality, nutrient-rich product that's ready to fuel your body and support your fitness goals. It's a testament to the marvels of modern food science and to the incredible transformative journey of whey protein from farm to shaker. Now it's time to take our concentrated whey from liquid to powder. This transformation is achieved through a process called spray drying. Picture this. The liquid whey is sprayed into a drying chamber, which is heated to high temperatures. As the droplets of whey enter the chamber, the heat causes the water in the whey to evaporate almost instantly, leaving behind tiny particles of dry whey protein. These particles then fall to the bottom of the chamber, where they are collected. This process is efficient, allowing for a large amount of whey to be dried quickly, and it also helps to retain the nutritional value of the whey protein. But we're not done yet. After all, we want our whey protein to be not just nutritious, but also tasty and easy to consume. This is where the mixing process comes in. The dried whey protein powder is now ready to be mixed with various ingredients to enhance its taste and nutritional profile. You might wonder what exactly goes into this mix. Well, the answer varies depending on the specific product. Some common additions include flavorings such as vanilla or chocolate to make the protein powder more palatable. Sweeteners are also often added to cater to those with a sweet tooth. But it's not just about taste. The whey protein powder can also be fortified with vitamins and minerals to boost its nutritional value. This is particularly common in products aimed at specific groups, such as athletes or those with certain dietary needs. For example, a whey protein powder for athletes might be fortified with extra amino acids to support muscle recovery, while a product for the elderly might contain added calcium for bone health. So, through the processes of spray drying and mixing, our concentrated whey is transformed into a tasty, nutritious protein powder ready to be consumed in a variety of ways, mixed into a smoothie, stirred into yogurt, or simply shaken up with water or milk. What we now have is the tasty, nutritious whey protein powder you know and love. Almost there. Let's talk about packaging and quality control. Once the whey protein has been dried into a powder and mixed with all kinds of goodies like flavorings and sweeteners, it's time to get it ready for distribution. The powder is transferred to a packaging area where it's all about precision. Imagine an assembly line of containers, each one waiting to be filled with a precise amount of this high-quality whey protein. This isn't done by hand, of course. The process is automated using advanced filling machines that ensure each container gets exactly the right amount of product. But it doesn't stop there. Each container also needs to be labeled. And these aren't just any labels. They include important information like the batch number, the nutritional information, and the best before date. It's crucial information for you, the consumer, to know what you're consuming and how fresh it is. Now, what about quality control? This is where the experts come in. These folks are trained to conduct taste tests and compare each batch to make sure it meets the brand's high standards. They check for consistency in flavor, texture, and overall quality. It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it. And it's not just about taste. The experts also perform tests to ensure the protein content is as stated on the label. They'll check for any impurities or contaminants that might have slipped through the production process. This rigorous quality control ensures that what you're getting is not just tasty, but safe and effective too. And that's it. Each container is sealed, packed, and ready to be shipped out. Whether it's heading to your local health food store or being delivered right to your doorstep, you can rest assured that a lot of care and attention has gone into making that product. And there you have it, your favorite whey protein ready to boost your fitness journey.